Praise God, but we just thank God for His Spirit. Amen. How many thank God for His Spirit? We call the Spirit of the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Holy Ghost and fire. Amen. So we just thank God for all of you. It's just so good to be able to worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Amen. Praise God. How many know that God wants to be worshipped? Scripture says that they that worship Him must worship Him in what? Spirit and in truth. Sometimes it takes us a while to kind of get hooked up to the flow of the Spirit. Sometimes the body doesn't want to cooperate. Sometimes the mind don't want to come into focus. Amen. The Spirit might be willing, but sometimes if we don't have a cooperation of the mind and the body, amen, not too much is going to happen. Amen. But I believe that we can pray and we can offer up thanksgiving and we can do some things that will bring the body, spirit, and soul into what? Unity. And we can begin to flow. Amen. And enjoy the Lord and the Holy Ghost. Oh, amen. I'm happy enough now to shout and to dance. Amen. We don't need no spirit. I mean, no music. Amen. All we need is the Spirit tonight. Glory. You know, it's a wonderful thing when we get to the point where we don't have to depend on the praise team and the music and the drums and all of the, amen, the instruments. Amen. I think it's good for us to be able to have our spirit of worship flowing from within. Isn't God good tonight? Isn't He good? Amen. We're not going to prolong the service tonight. We don't have a praise and worship team here. Amen. Other than that we have already on the inside. Amen. Somebody said, I got a telephone in my bosom and I can ring them up from my heart. Amen. Praise God. So we just want to, this time, just give up the service to our speaker. Amen. Brother Skills doesn't have to have a whole lot of singing and hollering and running and preliminary. Amen. He said he was ready when he got here tonight. It sounded like he's ready. He can't wait to get up here. So we just thank God for what God is about to do. And we just thank God for all of you that have come to join us in this service tonight. Amen. And we're just going to give the service over into the hands of our evangelists. All of us know. Dr. Sales, Reverend Scales, amen. Probably Apostle Sales by now. I don't know, amen. But he has been a blessing to us for many years, and I take the credit that when he first came to Tulsa, I was probably one of the first ministers that invited him over to speak. This was within a year after he had been saved. Amen. And we hear his testimony, and he just kept coming back. And before long, amen, he was traveling on the road and blessing people all over the nation. And he has brought salvation, deliverance, and healing to thousands and thousands, tens of thousands, probably hundreds of thousands. Amen. So we just thank God for what God is doing through him all of these years. So I have a little small part, amen, in this ministry. And I feel like I'm going to have a little small part, amen. And I believe that God is going to continuously use this man of God, amen, for His glory to fulfill the purpose and plan that He has raised him up for. Everybody on your feet. Let's just
hallelujah. We have to thank the Lord for what He has done. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God. It's a honor and a blessing to be here. Giving honor to my Father in heaven, my Master, the Lord Jesus. Pastor Hill and his lovely wife, Sister Marilyn. I love you all so much. All the saints here. I'm always having to be in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Praise God. I'm excited about today and tomorrow, and I pray you came expecting. I know the Lord is going to speak to us. And I want to go ahead and open your Bibles up to John chapter 14, verse 27. I want to teach the next couple of nights the best I can. Oh no, and that means I'm just going to get all I can in.
Yes.
Only let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. My, 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 my. Oh, we need to get a hold of that. We need to get a hold of that. Let not our hearts be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I wrote the definition of this word down. Let's read here. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world give I unto you. And let's listen to this commandment from Jesus. This word from the Master's lips. To let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. One thing I have learned over the years, I've been walking with the Lord for 23 years. One of the great truths that Jesus has taught me is when I read scriptures, never see I have to do that. Let me say that again. Whenever I read scriptures, I never have the pressure that I have to do that, but the pressure to trust Him. And so when Jesus tells us to don't let our hearts be troubled and neither let it be afraid, all of this is centered around the Lord being able to give us something. And so, saints, our whole Christian lives, from beginning to end, from faith to faith, should be centered around always the Lord giving us something. Always. In every trouble, in every situation, in every circumstance that you and I face, He has to give us something. There's something to be given. In every situation, when anybody came to Jesus with any situation, it was for Jesus to give them something.
Yes.
And so Jesus said, my peace, the New Living Translator said, my peace I give you as a gift. The word peace here, noting the absence of strife. That means what Jesus gives you, there's never any strife in it. It's never any double-mindedness. It's never could be another little way in it. A state of untroubled, undisturbed well-being. This word means in the Greek, prosperity. Jesus always giving us something. Always. And you need this peace every day of Jesus. If you're going to keep your mind from being troubled, then you have to stay in a place where Jesus is constantly giving you wisdom, grace, peace, joy, coming through for you.
Yes.
Making a way for you.
Yes.
Such a state of peace is the object of divine promise. Now listen to this, the rest of this definition. And is brought about by God's mercy, granting deliverance and freedom from all the distresses that are experienced as a result of sin. Everything we did wrong, Jesus' peace comes to fix it. And so, I believe we need to learn how to live in peace here today. And quit having to fight so much. And use our fight to trust the Lord instead of fighting problems and fighting stresses and fighting situations and live a life. Let me go to 1 John chapter 4, verse 16. You'll see some alarm in here. Praise the Lord. Now listen to this. You begin to see this gift. I'm going to build on this tonight, and tomorrow I'm going to run with this. We have known and believe the love that God has to us. This is the key of you always living in His peace. Is you always keeping awareness of knowing His love and believing in it. Knowing and believing the love that God has to us. God is love. He that gonna dwell in love dwelleth in God and God in you. So we have known and believed the love that God has to us. Do you really, he's writing to Christians, do you really know that? Do you know and believe? Not just know about it, but believe the love that God has to you. Do you really know that? And do you really believe that? Every day, in every situation, the love that God has to you. Or are you trying to love God? Are you stuck on trying to love God? Or are you stuck on He love you? Because you can't do both of them. And if He'll love you, you'll love Him. Really, really, saints, listen now what the Holy Spirit is telling you. Because the Holy Spirit has to reveal this to you. When you really love God, all that is you are loving how He has done you in Jesus. You can't love God no other way. You can't love your parents if they ain't loved you. No child come out of the womb and they say, love me. God don't demand us to love Him. He wants to love us. You have to love Him if He loves you. If He come through for you in every situation, you can't help but love somebody like that. He done saved you and forgave you of everything you ever did wrong. You got to love somebody like that if you believe in Him. We should love His love for us. We should love His forgiveness to us. We should love His mercy to us. When we live in how He loved us, we are loving Him. Yes. Don't look out and get in the cop drop. Are y'all following me? Yes. Now listen carefully. Go to verse 17. And verse 17 is a little different. And it's astounding that this can be reversed. And I didn't know it for years. So I'm not here to condemn nobody. But just to make this clear to you, in 1 John 4:17, herein, when he goes to